Hello students, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is relations and functions. Okay, this chapter you have already studied in 11th class. Aapko kaisa laga tha ye chapter? Interesting? It's a very small chapter, but ye hamare textbook ka first chapter hai, theek hai na? Chhota hai, but bahut sari cheeze hai jo aapko isme padhne hai. Okay, so let's start the topic, but before getting into the chapter, we'll just have a look that what are the things we are going to study today. Okay, first is we are going to study today the basic concept of relation. That means we will go through what is a Cartesian product, what is a relation, then we will see what are the different types of relation. Okay, we'll also do the first question of the exercise 1.1. okay, so let's start with the topic today, relations and functions. Now the first topic that I am going to explain you is Cartesian product. Okay, what is this? Cartesian product of sets. What is the meaning of Cartesian product of sets? This topic you have already studied in 11th class, but we'll just recall this ki ye hota kya hai, kya aapne ye sikha tha. Okay, now I am taking example here. Let us suppose that A is equal to a set 2, 4. Okay. B, another set 10, 20 and 30. Okay. What I am doing here, I am pairing it. Main isko ek ordered pair mein likh rahi hu. How I am writing? I am writing each and every element with this element ordered करके मैं लिख रही हूँ. तो कैसे लिख रही हूँ? Just see here, 2, 10, okay, 2, 20, right, 2, 30, okay, then 4, 10, 4, 20 and 4, 30, correct, 2, 10, 2, 20, 2, 30 and then 4, 10, 4, 20, 4, 30. What is this? This I have written the ordered pair of the set A with the set B. Okay, I have written all the elements in ordered pair, and this is known as the Cartesian product of two sets. Okay, Cartesian product of two sets. Okay, so what is Cartesian product? Cartesian product means when you form the ordered pairs of the first set with the other set. That means each and every element will be ordered with the each and every element of the second set. जब आप सारे pairs को लिखते हैं ना, वो आपका होता है Cartesian product. Okay? Now it is normally denoted by A cross B. Okay? इस तरह लिखा जाता है इसको. And you see here the number of elements also you can find here. Look at here, the number of elements in set A is how much? 2 elements are there. What about B? 3 elements are there. Okay? Then in A cross B, what will be the number of elements? Just calculate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How we are going to get this? This is a result. It is again, aap isko padhe hai, you have already studied. What is that? If the number of elements of the first set is m and the number of element of the second set is n, then the number of elements in A cross B will be m into n. Okay. So, is result say you can easily find how many number of elements will be there in A cross B. So this is the basic concept of Cartesian product. Okay, now let's see what is a relation. Relation kya hota hai, theek hai? Now look at here, relation is actually a English word, right? Ye ek English word hai. Hum apne puri zindagi mein hum relations ke bare mein dekhte hain, correct? But what is the importance in mathematics? Now I'll explain you by taking a real life situation. Okay, see here, this is my family. I'm taking my family. Okay, now what I'm doing here, I am dividing my family into two groups, correct? In the first group, I'm taking my father, okay, then my grandfather and my brother, correct? Okay, in the second set, what I am taking? I am taking mother, grandmother, okay, and sister-in-law, and my sister. Okay, I have divided my complete family into two groups. Okay, now if you want to form the Cartesian product, how you are going to find out? See here, A cross B will be what? A cross B will be what? Father, mother, father, grandmother, father, sister-in-law, father, sister. That means each and every element of set A will be paired with each and every element of set B. Okay, so I'm just writing the first alphabet here. Father, mother. Okay, then what you're going to get it? Father, grandmother. Okay, then next will be father, sister-in-law. ठीक है, उसके बाद आपको क्या मिलेगा? You're going to get here father, last is sister. Okay, next will be what? Next will be your grandfather, grandmother. ठीक है, grandfather, grandmother. Next will be grandfather, then grandfather के साथ पहले mother होगा, उसके बाद grandfather के साथ grandmother, and then you will see grandfather with sister-in-law. Okay, and then grandfather with sister. Okay, the next is brother. So B M, brother with the mother, brother with grandmother, brother with sister-in-law. Okay, and then brother with the sister. So this is the Cartesian product of these two sets. Okay, now you got the Cartesian product. Now we'll see what is the relation here. Now I am defining a relation. Main yahan pe ek relation bata rahi hu aapko. You have to form a relation x comma y such that x is husband, x is husband of y. Okay, where x is the, x is taken from the first set and y is taken from the second set. Now x is husband of y. So you can represent the relation in three ways. One is you can show with the arrow diagram, you can show with the roster form, and you can also write down in set builder form. Okay, this is actually set builder form. Now I'm showing in arrow diagram, so it will be like this, because we want husband wife relation. X is the husband of y, that means father mother, grandfather grandmother, brother sister in law. Sister is unmarried, to yahan pe iska koi relation nahi banega. Correct. Ab isko agar main roster form mein likhna chahu to kaise likhenge hum log? Look at here, I can write it down as father mother, then grandfather grandmother, and the last is your, what is that, brother and sister-in-law. So this is, I got it in roster form. Okay, now look at here, A cross B, you have ordered each and every element of set A with set B. Okay, but this is a relation that you have formed, right? Now look at here, whether this relation, the elements which are there in this relation, whether it's there in the A cross B also. Definitely yes. आप यहाँ पे देखो, father mother वहाँ पे भी है, grandfather grandmother is there, brother and sister law वो भी वहाँ पे है, है ना? That means you can say that R is a subset of A cross B. Always remember, relation जो भी आप बनाएंगे, it will be always the subset of A cross B. These things you have studied in 11th class, but still एक बार आपको मैं थोड़ा सा बता रही हूँ कि यहाँ पे जब आप रिलेशन की बात करेंगे, रिलेशन मीन्स इट इज ऑलवेज द सबसेट ऑफ ए क्रॉस बी. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डिफाइन रिलेशन, यू कैन से दैट अ रिलेशन इज द सेट ऑफ ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स दैट सैटिस्फाई द रिलेशनशिप. रिलेशन इज द सेट ऑफ ऑर्डर्ड पेयर दैट सैटिस्फाइज अ रिलेशनशिप. ओके, सी यू कैन सी द डेफिनेशन हियर. What is a relation? Set of ordered pairs that satisfy a relationship is known as relation. A relation R from set A to set B is subset of A cross B, where A and B are two non-empty sets. Clear? So this is the basic concept of relation. Now one more thing, as I told you before also, here see what is the number of element in the first set? 3. What about here? It is 4. Okay, so it is 3 elements and here it is 4 elements. How many elements will be there in A cross B? Definitely 3 into 4, 12 elements. You can count it. Aapko total yahan pe kitna milega? 12 elements milenge. Theek hai? To ye ek result hai. Ye bhi humne sikha hai 11th mein. Isse ek aur result aata hai. Wo kya hai? If A and B are finite sets consisting of M and N elements respectively, then A cross B has Mn ordered pairs. Therefore, the total number of relations from A to B is 2 to the power mn. Sometimes, questions aapko mil sakta hai ki aap number of relations find out kariye. How you are going to find the number of relations? You see here, this is your 3, okay? And this is your 4. How many elements will be there in A cross B? 12 elements. How many relations you can form? Is tarah ka aap kitna relations bana sakte hain? So, the result says that you can form 2 to the power mn. Mn means when you multiply m and n, the number of elements present in set A and the number of elements present in set B. When you multiply 2 to the power, that will be your number of relations you can form. Okay, that means here if you see, you can form 2 to the power 12. 2 to the power 12 relations you can form. So this is again an important result. Sometimes one mark may question aa sakta hai ki how many relations you can form. Okay. Now let's see the next topic. Ye to tha pura basic concept jo maine aapko bataya abhi. Theek hai? Ab hum chalte hai 12th ki syllabus ki taraf. Now what is that? The first thing that you have to study is the types of relation. Okay. Now let's see what are the types of relation here. The types of relations are empty relation, or you can say void relation, then universal relation, then reflexive relation, symmetric relation, transitive relation, and equivalence relation. Okay, so let's see the first relation, that is empty relation. Okay, empty relation. Now empty, what is the meaning of empty? Khali. Isko hum void relation bhi bolte hain. Theek hai? Now empty relation matlab kya hai? A set in कोई भी एक set में जब आप एक relation form करते हो, ठीक है, तो वहाँ पे कुछ होना चाहिए, कुछ elements होने चाहिए. But here a relation R in set A is said to be empty if no elements of set A is related to any element of set B. Okay, what does it mean? It means that suppose आपके पास एक set है, जैसे कि मैंने एक लिया, I have taken a set 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, you have to form a relation in which, I'm forming a relation here, okay, x comma y, in which you'll be getting x minus y is equal to 10. Look at here, you have got a set A 1, 2, 3, 4. That means you have to form a relation from set A to set A. Okay, set A se set A mein hi aapko relation banana hai. What is the relation you have to form? You have to form R is equal to XY, X minus Y is equal to 10. Ab yahan pe aap dekhiye, whether you are getting any relation in which when you subtract X and Y, you will be getting 10. No, because dekhiye 1 minus 2, aapko 10 nahi milega, 2 minus 3, 10 nahi milega, 1 minus 4. Kisi bhi element ke saath, agar aap subtract karenge, you are not going to get 10 there. That means this relation is a empty relation. You will not be going to get any ordered pair here. Okay, one more example I will explain you. See, myself, I am teaching in Government Girls Senior Secondary School. Okay, so I am taking the set of students in girls school. Set of students. So normally, set of students means girl child will be studying in girls school, correct? So if I am telling you to form a relation in which X is the brother of Y, is it possible there? Because girl school means only girl child. So you cannot form a child who is the brother of another child. Okay? So X will not be a brother of another child. Okay. So here you can say that the relation is an empty relation. Okay. Now the second is your universal relation. Now what is universal relation? So let's see. Universal relation means A relation R in set A is said to be universal if each and every element of set A is related to each and every element of set B. Okay. Now, this is the first one, empty relation. The second is your universal relation. Now, let's see what is universal relation. The same example I'll take, okay? The same example, that is A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. Now, I'm telling you to form a relation x, y such that absolute value of x minus y will be always greater than 0. Okay, absolute value of x minus y is always greater than 0. Now look at here. Definitely, when you apply this, abhi 1 minus 2, kyunki aap jo relation nikal rahe ho, it is from set A to set A. So 1 minus 2 is minus 1. ठीक है, that means positive होगा. आप किसी भी दो value को अगर आप subtract करेंगे और उसका absolute value निकालेंगे, आपको वो हमेशा positive मिलेगा. That means each and every element of set A is related to each and every element of set B. So what can you say? This relation is a universal relation. I think clear? आपको empty relation जहाँ पे कोई relation नहीं है, universal में जहाँ पे हर एक element दूसरे सारे element के साथ में related है, तो आप बोलोगे उसको universal relation. Now next comes your very important, that is reflexive relation. Now what is reflexive relation? Now let's see here. Reflexive. Okay. Now reflexive relation means a relation R is said to be reflexive if the same element will be related to the same element. What does it mean? मतलब खुद का खुद के साथ relation. अगर आप कहीं बता रहे हो, so that will be called as reflexive relation. For example, suppose you have got a set A is equal to 1, 2 and 3. Okay, you have got a set 1, 2, 3. Now here, I'm forming a relation 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. If you are getting a relation like this, you can say that this relation is reflexive because 1 is related to 1, 2 is related to 2, 3 is related to 3. So you can say that this is reflexive. But suppose if you are getting a relation like this, this is reflexive. Okay, not reflexive. Why it is not reflexive? Because 1, 1 is there, 2, 2 is there, but 3, 3 is not there. So you can say that this one, suppose ye R1 hai, theek hai? This relation is not reflexive, whereas this relation is reflexive. That means each and every element should be paired with the same element. Khud ka khud ke saath agar relation hota hai, tab aap usko kya batayenge? Reflexive relation. Okay, clear children? Now next see symmetric relation. Now what is symmetric relation? A relation R in a set A is said to be symmetric if AB belongs to R implies that BA should be present in the relation. What does it mean? That means suppose if you are taking a set A is equal to 1, 2, 3. Okay. Ye 4 bhi le lo aap. And if you are getting a relation 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, and 3, 2. If you are getting a relation like this, you can say that this relation is symmetric. That means A, B is present. ठीक है? B, A is also present. A, B यहाँ पे भी present है, उसका उल्टा भी present है. मतलब आप बोल सकते हो कि if A, B belongs to R, then B, A also belongs to R. When you're getting an expression like this, you can say that this relation is symmetric relation. ठीक है, समझ में आया आपको? Now we'll see the next one, that is your transitive relation. Now what is transitive relation? Look at here, transitive relation. Transitive. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of transitive? In transitive, suppose Suppose, again I am taking an example, A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, I am getting a relation in which 1, 2 is there, 2, 3 is there and 1, 3 is there. This is called transitive. 1, 2 is there, 2, 3 is there and 1, 3 is also there. That means this relation is called your transitive relation. What does it mean? Means A, B belongs to R. Okay, and B, C belongs to R implies that A, C belongs to R. If you are getting, if this two pair is available in the relation and third is also available, then you can say that the relation is a transitive relation. Clear? हाँ, अगर यहाँ पे पहला है लेकिन दूसरा नहीं है और दूसरा तीसरा दोनों नहीं है, तब भी आप वो रिलेशन को ट्रांजिटिव ही बोलेंगे, क्योंकि हमें पता नहीं है कि दूसरा वहां में होगा या नहीं होगा. तो आप, अगर आपके पास पहला आपसे पूछा गया ट्रांजिटिव बताओ, बट फर्स्ट इज देयर बट द सेकेंड पेयर इज नॉट देयर, थर्ड इज ऑल्सो नॉट देयर, स्टिल यू कैन से दैट इट इज ट्रांजिटिव रिलेशन. क्लियर चिल्ड्रन? ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट इज इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन. You can see in my slide, equivalence relation means, इसको तीन चीजें मैंने लिखी है उसके नीचे, आप देखिए, reflexive, symmetric and transitive. That means, a relation R is said to be equivalence if it is symmetric, reflexive and transitive. ये तीनों अगर होते हैं कोई भी relation, तो उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? Equivalence relation, which is very very important. Lots of question you are going to get for this, इस topic पे ही आपको questions मिलेंगे. ठीक है, एक्सरसाइज में आप देखोगे इस टॉपिक पे ज्यादा क्वेश्चंस हैं हमारे इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन के ऊपर में. तो क्लियर चिल्ड्रन? अ रिलेशन आर इज सेड टू बी इक्विवेलेंस इफ इट इज रिफ्लेक्सिव, सिमेट्रिक एंड ट्रांजिटिव. क्लियर? नाउ लेट्स सी वन एग्जांपल. लेट टी बी द सेट ऑफ ऑल ट्रायंगल्स इन अ प्लेन विद आर अ रिलेशन इन टी गिवन बाय आर इज इक्वल टू टी वन टी टू सच दैट टी वन इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू टी टू. शो दैट आर इज एन इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन. ओके, आपको दे रखा है कि T क्या है, सेट ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स है, और क्या बोला है, T1, T2, आपको ऐसा एक रिलेशन बनाना है जिसमें T1 जो है कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू T2. शो दैट ये जो रिलेशन है दिस इज इक्विवेलेंस. दैट मींस यू हैव टू शो इट इज रिफ्लेक्सिव, सिमेट्रिक एंड ट्रांजिटिव. ओके, सो लेट्स हैव अ लुक. दिस इज द क्वेश्चन गिवन टू यू, R इज इक्वल टू T1, T2, दिस इज द रिलेशन, T1 इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू T2. अब आपको ये देखना है कि ये रिफ्लेक्सिव है, सिमेट्रिक है एंड ट्रांजिटिव है. So let's start with first, that is reflexive. Now what is the meaning of reflexive? The meaning of reflexive is khud ke saath. That means ye jo T2 hai na, this T2 you have to replace it by T1. Got it? T1, T1 kya related hai? Ek triangle congruent hai. Kya wo khud se hi congruent hoga? Theek hai? You can see in my slide. See here. What do you see here? I have taken three triangles. You see, T1 is related to T1, T2 is related to T2 and T3 is also related to T3. That means a triangle is always congruent to itself. Hence, you can say that R is reflexive. Okay, what can you say? R is reflexive as T1, T1 belongs to R. That means a triangle is always, a congruent triangle is always congruent to itself. Okay, so this is reflexive. Clear? Now come to what is symmetric here. Whether this relation is symmetric, let's see here. What is the meaning of symmetric? If T1 is related to T2, whether T2 is related to T1. Let's see here the diagram. Transitive. Look at here. Aap isme dhyan se dekhiye, jo T1 jo triangle hai, वो T2 के साथ में कॉन्ग्रुएंट है. उल्टा होगा, T2 विल बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू T1 और नॉट, दैट यू हैव टू सी हियर. ओके, नाउ लुक एट हियर, व्हेन T1 इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू T2, दैट मींस T1 T2 बिलोंग्स टू R. ठीक है, एक ट्रायंगल है जो T2 के कॉन्ग्रुएंट है, लेकिन आप उसको अगर रिवर्स लोगे T2 और T1, तो दूसरा ट्रायंगल भी उसका कॉन्ग्रुएंट होगा. You know what is congruency? ठीक है ना? तो T1, T2 congruent means T2, T1 is also congruent. That means you can say that T1 and T2 belongs to R implies that T2, T1 also belongs to R. That means R is symmetric. Clear? Now the third part is transitive. Now what is the meaning of transitive here? Transitive means if you have taken three triangles T1, T2 and T3, if T1 is related to T2 and T2 is related to T3, let's see here, T1, T2 belongs to R. That means these two triangles are congruent and T2, T3 belongs to R. That means T2, T3 is also congruent. Okay, then whether, that implies whether T1 and T3 are congruent triangle. You can see here diagrammatically T1 is related to T2. ठीक है, congruent है. T2, T1 के भी congruent है. मैंने arrow mark से दिखाया है, यहाँ पे देखिए. तो definitely आप बोल सकते हैं यहाँ पे कि T3 जो है वो T1 के congruent होगा, है ना? क्योंकि यही definition है congruency के, है ना? So you can say that T1, T2 belongs to R. T2, T3 belongs to R. That means you can say that T1 and T3 also belongs to R. That means here you can say that R is transitive. So you have proved here R is reflexive, you have proved R is symmetric, you have also proved R is transitive. So you have proved that R is an equivalence relation, because we know that to prove equivalence you have to prove it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. So you can say that hence R is equivalence relation. Okay, clear children? This is the way you have to solve the questions. Okay, now let's see exercise problem here. Determine whether each of the following relations are reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Okay, you have to see whether the relation is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Now look at the first question. Relation R in the set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc., 13, 14, defined as R is equal to xy, 3x minus y is equal to 0. Now look at here, the first question. A is given set till 14 तक आपको numbers दिए हैं, defined as R is equal to x comma y such that 3x minus y is equal to 0. Now you have to see whether this relation is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Okay, now first of all I am going to write this relation in roster form. ठीक है, roster form में अगर आप लिखोगे तो देखिए इसको आप यहाँ पे कैसे लिख सकते हैं, x comma y such that y is equal to 3x. Clear? I can write 3x minus y is equal to 0 as y is equal to 3x. Now I am forming ordered pair. When x is 1, when x is 1, जब आप x को यहाँ पे 1 डालेंगे, तो y कितना होगा? 3. The first relation you got it, okay? When x is 2, y will be how much? 6. When x is 3, y will be your 9. When x is 4, y will be your 12. ठीक है, इसके आगे हम डालेंगे, क्योंकि व्हेन एक्स इज 5 y विल बी योर 15, जो यहाँ पे नहीं है वो नंबर, तो हम सिर्फ 12 तक ही लेंगे यहाँ पे. ठीक है, तो यू गॉट द रिलेशन एज 1 3 2 6 3 9 4 12. नाउ बाय सीइंग दिस रिलेशन यू हैव टू से वेदर इट इज रिफ्लेक्सिव, ट्रांजिटिव, सिमेट्रिक एंड ट्रांजिटिव. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी वेदर इट इज रिफ्लेक्सिव और नॉट. ओके, लेट्स सी हियर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रिफ्लेक्सिव. दैट मीन्स If AB belongs to R means AA should be present in R. Same का same के साथ present होना चाहिए. तो यहाँ पे क्या लग रहा है आपको, यहाँ पे present है क्या? देखिए 1 1 या 2 2, 3 3 4 4, कोई भी element नहीं है. So you can say that R is not reflexive. Why it is not reflexive? As A comma A does not belongs to R. For example, 1, 1 is not there, 2, 2 is not there, 3, 3 is not there. आप वो बता सकते हैं. For example, 1, 1, 2, 2 is not present in R. So it is not reflexive. Okay. Now we'll go for symmetric. Now how to prove it is symmetric? Symmetric है कि नहीं? 1, 3, 3, 1 तो नहीं है. 2, 6, 6, 2 is also not there. 3, 9, 9, 3 is also not there. 4, 12, 12, 4 is also not there. So it is not symmetric. It is not symmetric. So what you will write down? R is not symmetric. Why R is not symmetric? As A comma B belongs to R, but B comma A does not belongs to R. देखिए आप, 1,3 तो है, but 3,1 is not there. 2,6 है, but 6,2 is not there. So इस तरह के जो रिवर्स वाले जो एलिमेंट्स हैं, 1,3 या 3,1, ऐसे एलिमेंट्स यहाँ पे नहीं है. So आप इसको क्या बोलोगे? R is not symmetric. Now let's see whether it is transitive or not. Okay? अब हम देखेंगे कि ये transitive है कि नहीं. Now look at here, whether it is transitive or not. Okay, what is the meaning of transitive? AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, then AC should be present in R. If you are getting that type of relation, you can say that it is transitive. Look at here, 1,3 is there. Okay, 3,9 is there, but 1,9 is not there. Again, 2,6 is there, 6,2 तो है ही नहीं यहाँ पे. वैसे 4,12, no. ये दो पेयर तो है यहाँ पे, लेकिन 1,9 इस रिलेशन में नहीं है. तो आप क्या बोलोगे? R is not transitive. Why it is not transitive? As A comma B is present and B comma C is also present, but A comma C is not present in R. You can also explain with an example also, like 1,3 belongs to R and 3,9 also belongs to R, but 1,9 does not belongs to R. So you can say that it is not transitive. So this relation is not reflexive, not symmetric, not transitive. So this is the way you have to proceed to solve the questions. Okay, now second question bhi aap ghar pe karenge, isi tarah karna hai aapko. थर्ड भी बहुत आसान है, आप कर सकते हैं. रिलेशन R इन द सेट A इज इक्वल टू 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 दिया है. एज R इज इक्वल टू एक्स वाई, वाई इज डिविजिबल बाई एक्स. मतलब आपको ऐसा एक रिलेशन बनाना है जहाँ पे Y जो है X से डिविजिबल होगा. तो कैसे होगा रिलेशन? मैं सिर्फ रिलेशन बता रही हूँ यहाँ पे, बाकी आप कर सकते हो. आई जस्ट टेल यू हाउ टू फॉर्म द रिलेशन, बिकॉज यू हैव टू राइट डाउन द रिलेशन इन रोस्टर फॉर्म. वेन यू राइट डाउन द रिलेशन इन रोस्टर फॉर्म, देन ओनली यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट whether it is reflexive, symmetric or transitive. Okay, तो यहाँ पे आप देखेंगे relation क्या बताया है. A is equal to given to B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, आपको दिया है 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. और आपको relation बनाना है. कैसे बनाना है? ordered pair में Y is divisible by X. तो सबसे पहले सारे numbers खुद से तो divisible है ही, तो आप लिखेंगे 3,3, 4,4, 5,5 and 6,6. Look at here, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. The next will be 1,2 and then, क्योंकि हर कोई एलिमेंट 1 से डिविजिबल है, 1,3, 1,4, 1,5 and 1,6, ये भी आएगा. ठीक है, और क्या आएंगे बताइए? You have to see that y is divisible by x, that means 2,4, ये से डिवाइड हो रहा है. और क्या होगा? 2,6. करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट विल बी व्हाट? 3,6 विल बी आल्सो देयर. एनी अदर? नो, ओनली दिस मच आई थिंक. ठीक है, 1,1, 2,2, ये देख लिए, ये एलिमेंट्स आपको मिल गए. नाउ बाय सीइंग दिस एलिमेंट्स यू हैव टू से वेदर दिस रिलेशन इज रिफ्लेक्सिव, सिमेट्रिक और ट्रांजिटिव. आप आराम से देख सकते, देखो 1, 1, 2, 2 सब सेम के साथ, सेम का ऑलरेडी है यहाँ पे, तो ये तो रिफ्लेक्सिव है. ओके, एंड सिमेट्रिक इज ऑल्सो देयर. आप देखिए यहाँ पे सिमेट्रिक 1,2 इज देयर, 2,1 है कहीं पे, या 1,3 या 3,1 है कहीं पे? नो, इट्स नॉट देयर. दैट मीन्स इट इज नॉट सिमेट्रिक. ओके, सिमेट्रिक नहीं है. ट्रांजिटिव आप इसमें देख के बता सकते हैं. ट्रांजिटिव यहाँ पे देखिए, यहाँ पे 1,2 इज देयर, 2,6 इज देयर एंड 1,6 इज ऑल्सो देयर. ओके, तो ये ट्रांजिटिव है. ये सिमेट्रिक है, सॉरी रिफ्लेक्सिव है, सिमेट्रिक नहीं है, बट ये ट्रांजिटिव है. ओके, क्लियर चिल्ड्रन? सो बिफोर कंक्लूडिंग द चैप्टर, विल जस्ट हैव अ रीकैप. वी हैव स्टडीड द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रिलेशंस. ओके, इन दैट वी हैव सीन कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट एंड व्हाट इज द रिलेशन वी हैव सीन. वी हैव स्टडीड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रिलेशन ऑल्सो. ओके, एंड वी हैव डन सम क्वेश्चंस ऑल्सो. आई होप द क्वेश्चंस विच आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू इज क्लियर टू यू, बट प्रैक्टिस एट होम. ओके, विल कंटिन्यू द सेम एक्सरसाइज प्रॉब्लम इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. So, thank you so much and keep learning.